All right, let's check out the reports and quizzes and how perfect they are for giving you exactly the information you need so you can guide your instruction. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna show you some of the higher level things that you can use that data for, you can see it in different ways, and then I'll show you some of the other individual things that are smaller, but I think also really powerful. All right, so first here, take a look. There's a couple different views you can look at it. So I think overview is exactly what it sounds like, where you can quickly at a glance see, okay, cool. Generally as a class, lots of green, great. Question one, maybe not so great. This is where we need to really spend our focus. And then of course, as an individual person, you can see their score as well. So you can see the individual person, individual score, and kind of an overview. So this is my favorite view. But then you can look at individual questions too and break it down to, okay, so they're getting this wrong, you know, but a lot of people are thinking that Vermont is actually this shape. So again, perfect for knowing exactly where to go with your instruction. And then for your participants here, again, it breaks it down a little bit more into some of the details as far as what you can see. And the fourth and final view is the standards view. So if you're tagging standards to the questions, it also allows you to see exactly what standards in general people are doing really well with, and the ones that people are struggling with, and it gives you an individual as well. So those are like the four views that I think give you everything you need to take the information, and then of course, deliver, you know, the new information using this data. But I want to show you some of the other parts that are in here that, again, I think are really, really good. So one is that you can share a report with whoever you want, whether that be a co-teacher or a principal or a department lead or even a parent. And you can download and print as well. It gives you some other statistics, which are, again, are all also really good. I like to email the parents. This is part of here, and you'll see right here, with a click, you can just email all the parents, and they'll say, this is how your student did, and give them the breakdown and give them their own report. And if you set up your classes, you'll have the email addresses already popped in here. There's also this evaluate button, which is right here, which is really good. So like, let's just say this person gets this one wrong, right? And you're like, you know what? They were actually absent this day. They probably shouldn't have got that question wrong. It's really easy for you to go in and change it. Okay, you know what? Let's at least give them partial credit or things like that. So as much as Quizizz grades for you, which is such a huge time saver, you still have the flexibility to go in there and modify any kind of grading and stuff that you need to. And if you have the LMS integration with Google Classroom or Canvas or Schoology, you'll see all the grades and stuff will sync directly to that, which again is very, very helpful if you're using those platforms. If you gave your students multiple attempts to do this, because you can set it in quizzes, say one time only, or you know, do as many times as you need. You can see what their best attempt was, their first one and their last one. You can also sort it here by accuracy, by score, if you're entering in your grade book, if you want to do it by first name. So what I'm trying to say is that it has everything you need to get the information and deliver a good lesson, but also tons of really great small features that just make it a really dynamic experience for teachers.